scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 275 pounds, Drew McIntyre!
You know, Corey, Drew McIntyre was in a bad mood even before Austin Theory put his foot in his mouth a few moments ago. I spoke to Drew earlier today. He said he is sick and tired of people sneak attacking him, ambushing him, talking about him, and he's going to start making examples of people here in WWE.
Well, the problem for Drew McIntyre is everybody on the roster is trying to make the exact same journey to the top of the mountain. McIntyre now holds the position of a bit of a gatekeeper to the WWE Undisputed Universal Championship, which is why Drew himself is considered a target to many.
And the thing about McIntyre, Corey, yeah, he lost to Roman Reigns. Solo Sikoa got involved. It was controversial. But you never heard Drew complain about it. He never made any excuses. He understood the situation. He's still raring to go.
I completely agree with you. McIntyre fights valiantly, never complains, just wants to let his actions prove that he's the best.
Now, speaking of people who complain,
I thought you were going to talk about people who are the best. Not only is he the best, Theory's brilliant too. The Alpha Academy is here.
Dude, would you expect anything different?
Of course not. Not from a brilliant competitor like Austin Theory.
And his opponent, accompanied to the ring by Alpha Academy. He is the youngest Mr. Money in the Bank in WWE history.
Drew McIntyre's gusto, his guts, his grit. But I think tonight, McIntyre may have stepped in it.
I like to refer to these three as the fake Mensa Club.
On what ground?
Well, because they appear and try to be much more intelligent than people say they are. Now, not my words. People have said that. I've heard that back in the locker room.
What people, Cole? You talk about the Winnipegs here in the arena?
That's real nice, Corey. That's real nice to insult our WWE fans.
They can't hear
me. We are in Winnipeg.
Yeah, I know. What do they call the natives?
So McIntyre and Theory one-on-one here tonight. Alpha Academy, Otis and Chad hanging out at ringside. I'm not quite sure how wise that was to piss McIntyre off even more than he was when he came into the matchup. Mr. Money in the Bank. Remember, Austin still has in the briefcase the contract. He can cash in any place, any time for the Undisputed Championship.
Oh, dear.
Remember, Austin tried to do that back at Clash at the Castle, and he got knocked out by Tyson Fury before he could actually cash in.
Oh, my God. Watch this power from McIntyre.
Oh! Vertical suplex turned into a beanbag toss.
Do they have cornhole here in Canada?
Well, Drew just displayed that he'd be pretty good at it. And Austin Theory hanging on, and he has no interest in really going toe-to-toe with Drew, I don't believe.
The only thing Austin Theory has interest in is going toe-to-toe with McIntyre and not having to worry about anybody punching him in the face from the front row like Tyson Fury did.
Tremendous talent is Austin Theory off the dropkick now, hammering away on McIntyre. Theory found his opening and capitalized. No doubt that Austin Theory may be one of the most talented superstars in many, many years here in WWE. He could use an attitude adjustment, though.
Theory now just hammering away on McIntyre. Uh-oh. Future Shock DDT spikes Theory.
Into a kip up now for McIntyre. And now McIntyre about to bring Austin Theory to Claymore Country. Chad Gable, however, getting involved.
Well, it's not going to force a disqualification because Gable didn't.
And now Otis dragging McIntyre.
Otis has never been the brightest in the academy.
Yeah, going to be a disqualification as Otis now drives McIntyre into the steel steps. Otis and Chad, who've been embarrassed by the monster among monsters the past few weeks, taking out some of that frustration now in McIntyre. And this is a three-on-one assault of the Scottish Warrior. And you had to believe, Corey, something like this was going to go down when the Alpha Academy wandered out here.
Otis, Chad Gable, and Austin Theory mugging Drew McIntyre. Wait, no.
But perhaps McIntyre has got some help. The man who returned to Monday Night Raw a few weeks ago, Johnny Gargano, former ally of Austin Theory, is here.
Gargano's been a thorn in the side of the Academy since arriving on Monday Night Raw.
And Johnny Gargano is not done yet. Going after Theory and now Gable from behind. And Gargano in a fight, once again in a numbers game, just like they did with McIntyre, will overtake Johnny Gargano here.
This will teach Mr. Wrestling to not stick his nose where it doesn't belong.
And back to McIntyre's. Uh-oh! Things just changed in a hurry! Kevin Owens is here!
Owens making a beeline for the melee in the ring!
And Kevin Owens is even the odds! And KO unloading on Theory in the Alpha Academy!
There goes Theory!
There goes Gable! On the super kick after super kick! And a Glasgow kiss by McIntyre! And Kevin Owens through McIntyre! And Johnny Gargano set Theory in the Academy reeling! Theory and the Academy are ticked off! But they brought that upon themselves.
I cannot believe Johnny Gargano and Kevin Owens on Friday Night Smackdown.